The Royal Australian Air Force has some of the best aircraft in the world. The F-35s, Growlers, the Super Hornets, and the autonomous Ghost Bat drone. But none of these planes would be able to take to the skies and reach the battlefield without support. An invisible backbone keeping them in the air, keeping them fueled, and keeping them loaded with battlefield intelligence and support. The tankers, the command aircraft, the transporters, the drones, these form the rear guard that keep the RAAF flying. Today, we're doing a full rundown of the RAAF's support fleet. What each aircraft does, why it matters, and how it transforms Australia's ability to project power across the Indo-Pacific. I'm Mel Pikos, and today, we're talking tactics. C-17A Globemaster III. Let's start with the heavy hitter, the C-17A Globemaster. When Australia bought its first one back in 2006, everything changed. Before this, we pretty much couldn't move large loads across the world quickly. The C-17 solved that overnight. This thing is a flying warehouse. It's 53 meters long with a wingspan of 51.75 meters. It can fly at a max height of 45,000 feet at a cruising speed of Mach 0.74 or 829 kilometers per hour and has a range of 10,390 kilometers with paratroopers. Each C-17 is capable of carrying 5 Bushmasters or 3 Black Hawk helicopters or 75 tons of equipment and supplies or just park a Chinook helicopter in the back, whatever the mission needs. And the best part is it can land on short, rough strips that look way too small for an aircraft of this size. The C-17 has been everywhere with the RAAF. Afghanistan, Iraq, Fiji, cyclone relief, bushfire evacuations, COVID medical flights, even missions supporting Ukraine. If a C-17 launches, it's because something urgent is happening. And with 8 of these beasts in the fleet, Australia has one of the best heavy lift capabilities outside of the United States. C-130J-30 Hercules. Next is the aircraft that does a bit of everything, the C-130J Hercules. Australia has been flying the Herc for decades, and the current J model continues that legacy. It's the perfect mid-range lifter. With a length of 34.4 meters and a wingspan of 40.4 meters, it can carry 19 tons of cargo, cruises at about 640 kilometers an hour, and can move 90 plus troops or drop paratroopers out the back. But the real magic of the Hercules is where it can go. Dirt strips, gravel strips, remote communities, Pacific islands, anywhere you can scrape together a runway, the Hercules can work with it. It handles everything from humanitarian drops to tactical resupply to evacuations. If it's not a job for the C-17, chances are it's a job for the Herc. We have 12 Hercules in the fleet at the moment, but 20 more have been ordered and are expected to be delivered in 2027. C-27J Spartan. Below the Herc is the C-27J Spartan, the aircraft for when even the Hercules is too big. This thing is designed for tiny, rough, improvised runways. It's basically a flying four-wheel drive. The Spartan carries around 5 tons, seats 34 troops, flies at 670 kilometers an hour, and has an impressive range for its size at around 1700 kilometers. It's a bridge between helicopters and larger transports. Humanitarian missions, special operations support, disaster relief, small team movements, that's its niche. The RAAF operates 10 Spartans, which are based at Amberley in Queensland. KC-30A Multi-Role Tanker Transport. Now, the KC-30A, one of the smartest procurement decisions Australia has ever made. It's a tanker, it's a transport, it's a long-range VIP passenger aircraft all in one airframe. Actually, a heavily modified Airbus A330 airliner, the KC-30A is 59 meters in length and has a wingspan of 60.3 meters. It can carry 111 tons tons of fuel, can refuel almost every Allied aircraft, and can also transport over 270 passengers. It eases pressure on the C-130s and C-17s. The seven KC-30A MRTTs give the RAAF enormous flexibility and long-range endurance. Honestly, the KC-30 might be one of the most strategically important aircraft Australia owns. 737 Boeing Business Jet. Then there's the 737 Boeing Business Jet, the RAAF's VIP aircraft. This is used for government, diplomatic, and high-level defense travel. Effectively, it's Australia's version of Air Force One.
Get off my plane.
It flies over 11,000 kilometers, cruises close to 850 kilometers per hour, and has secure communications on board. It seats 32 passengers and includes conference tables and facilities to allow the continuation of government business during transport. The RAAF operates two of these business jets. They're not really combat aircraft, but are essential for national leadership, diplomacy, and crisis response. Anytime a prime minister or defense minister needs to move quickly and securely, this is the aircraft doing that job. KA350 King Air. Next up, the King Air. This is a small, quiet, and reliable twin-engine turboprop plane based at RAAF-based East Sale. It's used mainly for training at the Air Mission Training School, but is occasionally used for light transport. It flies 570 kilometers an hour, carries up to 8 passengers, and can be configured for a number of roles, including air logistics support, near region international engagement, image acquisition, and base station relay. The RAAF operates 12 King Air 350s. These planes keep day-to-day operations running smoothly without tying up larger aircraft. Dassault Falcon 7X. Australia has added the Dassault Falcon 7X to the fleet in 2019, a long-range VIP and specialist transport jet. It complements the Boeing Business Jet as a special purpose passenger and VIP transport. It runs with a standard crew of 3 plus up to 14 passengers. It has a range of 11,000 kilometers non-stop, and there's varying numbers listed for the max speed. Most say it has a max speed of Mach 0.9, which is roughly 950 kilometers an hour or so. The RAAF website also says this, but they also say that it only has an equivalent to a max speed of 685 kilometers per hour. Maybe they haven't really opened it up to see how fast they can get it going, but in any event, it gives defense a fast, efficient way to move senior personnel across the world. Australia has 3 of these aircraft, and they're ideal for high priority missions where you don't want to dedicate a KC-30 or Boeing business jet. P-8A Poseidon. Now let's get into the specialized aircraft, starting with the P-8A Poseidon. This is Australia's premier maritime patrol and anti-submarine warfare aircraft, and it's absolutely essential. We have 13 Poseidons in service, with a 14th ordered and expected to be delivered by the end of 2026. This is a multi-mission maritime patrol aircraft. They undertake anti-submarine warfare, anti-surface warfare, search and rescue, intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance. The Poseidon is a modified Boeing 737-800 and includes a weapons bay, underwing and under fuselage hardpoints for weapons, a sonobuoy deployment system, and increased structural strength for low-level operations down to 200 feet. It can carry weapons such as the AGM-84 Harpoon anti-ship missiles and lightweight anti-submarine torpedoes. It's 39.5 meters long and has a wingspan of 37.6 meters. It flies 907 kilometers per hour and has ranges of 7,500 kilometers and has a crew of 9. In today's Indo-Pacific environment, having a strong fleet of P-8s is non-negotiable. E-7A Wedgetail. And now, Australia's masterpiece, the E-7A Wedgetail. Although it's based on the Boeing 737 airframe, the E-7A Wedgetail was designed in Australia and built with Australian technology. And it's widely considered to be one of the best, if not the best, airborne early warning and control aircraft in the world right now. It provides Australia with advanced airspace battle management capabilities. It can coordinate a joint air, sea, and land battle in real time and significantly increases the effectiveness of the combined Australian Defence Force. The Wedgetail carries a multi-role electronic scanned array radar with a range in excess of 400 kilometres. It can track hundreds of targets at once, aircraft, missiles, ships, and direct an entire air battle in real time. It's 33.6 meters long and a wingspan of 34.3 meters, cruises at 760 kilometers per hour with a max speed of 755 kilometers per hour, and typically runs with 16 crew, including mission specialists. It has a range of 7,040 kilometers and can cover more than 4 million kilometers in a standard mission. That's roughly the size of Western Australia. And with in-flight refueling, it's capable of unlimited long-range deployment. Australia has deployed Wedgetails in the Middle East, throughout the Indo-Pacific, and to support major international operations. It's not just good, it's world-leading. A genuine Australian defence success story. I absolutely love it. MQ-4C Triton. The MQ-4C Triton is the RAAF's new long-endurance, high-altitude, maritime surveillance, remotely piloted platform. Based at RAAF Base Tyndall and operated remotely by No. 9 Squadron from Edinburgh, it gives Australia eyes over the ocean for more than 24 hours at a time, far longer than any crewed aircraft. Instead of a pilot in the cockpit, Triton is flown by RAAF pilots from a ground station, supported by a co-pilot and a full intelligence and operations team who analyze everything the aircraft collects in real time. Originally developed by the US Navy, Triton is an evolution of the Global Hawk, strengthened for maritime missions. It has a reinforced airframe, de-icing, and lightning protection, allowing it to drop through cloud layers and get closer views of ships and targets at sea. It has a range of 15,000 kilometers, a ceiling height of 50,000 feet, and a speed of 600 kilometers per hour. It's still new to Australia, but its sheer endurance and wide area coverage will transform how the RAAF patrols and protects our vast maritime approaches. So that's the RAAF support fleet, the aircraft people don't always think about, but the ones that make everything possible. The C-17 gives us global reach. The KC-30A extends every mission in the sky. And the Triton is redefining long-range surveillance and will continue for decades to come. Air power is never just about fighters. It's about the entire fleet working cohesively together. If there's a specific aircraft you want a full deep dive on next, let me know in the comments section. And tell me what other aircraft we should look at acquiring. I've said previously that Australia should purchase the B-21 Raider stealth bomber from the USA. To find out why, you need to check out this video next. But that's it for today. I'm Mel Pikos, and we've been talking tactics.